Hello students, in the last video we learned how to write the formula of a compound. Now let us see one more example of magnesium sulfate. We will write symbols of elements of which it is made up of. In step 1 we will write the symbols. Symbol of magnesium is Mg and for sulfate it is SO4. In step 2, write the valencies on the top as superscript. Means we will write the valencies. As you know, the valencies of magnesium and sulfate, they are same. So we will divide them by the common factor. In step 3, interchange the valencies. Interchange the valencies and write them as a subscript. अब हमें इनको interchange करना है. In step 4, we get the formula magnesium sulfate. In table 3.9, it is showing the chemical formula of some compounds and you have to practice it. Now, what is chemical equation? The elements or the compounds that take part in a chemical change or a reaction, they are called the reactants, and the elements which form the new compounds, they are called the products. In a chemical equation, I am taking the example of iron and sulfur. Symbol of iron is Fe and for sulfur it is S and it is iron sulfide. In first point it is written between the reactant and the products an arrow sign is placed. Here I place the arrow sign. In the second point the reactants are written on the left hand side of the arrow. These are known as reactants. And the products they are written on the right hand side. What is the definition of chemical equation? A chemical equation shows the result of a chemical reaction in which the reactant and the products they are represented by a symbol or a formula. As I placed a symbol of iron, that is Fe, and for sulfur it is S. So when the chemical reaction takes place between this, a new compound iron sulfide is formed. An important requirement for writing an equation is that the number of atoms of each element on the left hand side should be the same as the number of atoms on the right hand side. Like in this example, the number of the product, that is iron sulfide, here the number of atoms of iron, that is 1, and for sulfur it is 1. On the reactant side the number of iron atom is 1 and sulfur is 1. Means in both the cases the number of atoms they are same, so this equation is balanced. We know that the water can be broken up into its constituent elements hydrogen and oxygen. So hydrogen and oxygen, is this correct? No. Why it is not correct? As you know, the hydrogen and oxygen, they exist in pairs because they are diatomic in nature. Second thing, the number of hydrogen atoms on the left hand side, that should be equal to the number of hydrogen atoms on the right hand side. Let us see how we can balance this equation. Here hydrogen and oxygen jo hain wo diatomic hain, that's why I have written H2 and O2. So is this equation is balanced? No. Why it is not balanced? Because the number of oxygen atoms on the product side, that is 2, and on the reactant side it is 1. Now we have to balance this equation. we can increase the number of oxygen atom by putting 2 here. I am adding 2. With this 2 number of oxygen atom either increase hoge. So number of oxygen atom now it is balanced. Oxygen 2, oxygen 2. But whenever I put 2 here, the number of hydrogen atom has increased, but it is 2 here. So here it is 4, 2 to the 4. So how we can balance it? I will put 2 here to increase the number of hydrogen atoms. Now number of hydrogen 4, here it is 4. Now this equation is balanced. Let's take one more example of nitrogen and hydrogen. It forms ammonium. Is this equation is balanced? No, it is unbalanced. Why it is unbalanced? Because the number of nitrogen on the reactant side is 2, here it is 1. Now we have to balance it. How we can make we can balance it? We will put 2 here to increase the number of nitrogen atoms. Number of nitrogen is same, but the number of hydrogen that has increased on the product side, 2, 3, the 6. To increase the hydrogen, number of hydrogen atoms, we will put 3 here. Now, this equation is balanced. Number of hydrogen, 6, here it is 6. Number of nitrogen, 2, here it is 2. Now, this equation is balanced. That's all for today. Now this chapter is over. We will do question answers.